Hey, what's up guys, it's Fishhh and welcome back to the next installment of my Bordeleaux campaign on the new Bretonnian Free LC. I just want to start off by saying a massive thank you to all the love this series got in the previous episode. I think it ended up around about 9,000 views and a ton of really nice comments. So I just want to say a massive thank you. You know, sometimes these Let's Plays do dwindle off and people do lose interest, but it was amazing to see just the sheer amount of support on the episode and also the support for replay battles. I think I'm going to be doing a lot more of them throughout this series, especially in the bigger battles, just because it's easier to control, especially as well in battles where I need to kind of focus more. So yeah, hopefully we'll do more replay battles and I hope that you guys will look forward to that. We last left off, we managed to defeat a pretty large army from Estalia. They've got their remnants of this army like cowering up here to the north, which is absolutely fine with me. Estalia have now rebuilt their former strength, which is, again, I find this so annoying that the way they deal with difficulty in this game is they just give the AI a ton of armies. Estalia have one province. They shouldn't be able to field 2.5 fucking full stacks. It's such a dumb mechanic in the game, and that's something which really does grind my gears, is the fact that these guys can just, you know, hold, because we're playing on very hard, I assume that's the reason why, these guys can just have 2.5 stacks. Like, it doesn't make any sense. Whereas I guess I could have another stack, but only just about. You know, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 provinces, and I can only just about have 2 stacks. Like, it's just such a dumb thing. It really, really is. But enough of that rant. Let's get back to what we were talking about. So we're continuing on our confederation path. We really did want to go ahead and continue that. We also got water pump, which is great because it gives us more peasant tree as well, which was really, really nice. I mean, I'm going to continue going down this path of just getting closer and closer to confederating with everyone. I don't think anyone does want to confederate with us right now, because our strength rating is really, really crappy. Maybe you will confederate with us. You would. Oh, we could confederate with these guys. That would mean that we would now be probably at war with the Beastmen. I'm not sure if we'd get dragged into their wars if we confederate. But that is a lot of land down to the south. Does anyone else want to confederate with me who isn't like a complete maniac? Not really. And I doubt you want to confederate with me as well. It would also mean we get another legendary lord, which is always nice. I doubt you do, yeah. So we could confederate with her. We probably only have this one shot. I mean, actually, there's only a Beastman army right there. This army could just sally out and slaughter it, probably. Oh, yeah, I would assume. So cool, yeah, let's confederate with her. Hell yeah. That's a large portion of land we just get. Greetings. My wise, so let's confederate with her. We are now on her team, and we are also, yeah, so she joins us, but we don't go into her wars, so we're not at war with anyone down there. Yeah, with the wood elves or the beastman herd. That's great. We obviously in a ton of debt now, and look at our peasantry, but we do get a ton more peasants as well. So confederating with her is great. She does have some pretty interesting buildings, the Tower of the Enchantress, giving us some pretty good magic. We've got a nice stable down here we can use. A nice military barracks. Oh, if we upgrade this, we can actually get foot squires from down here. That's pretty good. So we can definitely get rid of this army. We definitely can get rid of this army. And with her army, that's kind of cool. She like wanders around. That is pretty cool. I like that. So yeah, you should definitely get out of your attrition. Don't know why you're there. And go garrison that. We got the Grail Knights as well. That's sick. That is so sick. What's that bonus? Oh, that's cool. So the Grail Knights must be so powerful, yeah. So let's get rid of these, obviously, these mob. We need to sort out our peasant economy. So let's get rid of them. Get rid of some of these spearmen we really don't need. Obviously, we have to be careful because we could just all of a sudden get these beastmen to declare war on us. But this army's kind of good. She can't force march back to... Or she can force march back to this town, which we will do. Great. So we're making a bit more money. We're not making as much money as we once were, obviously, but we have another army. That army is kind of good to help garrison up this entire area, which is now pretty happy. We've got the nice Manan's dry dock on the way, which gives us 1,200 gold a turn. And obviously we have these armies down here as well. This army is going to kind of be a nice little supporting army for the king, I think, or for the duke. And we'll use him as kind of like a soldier to move around the battlefield and just kind of turn up with some cavalry who can get over to the main army really, really fast. Just pick up a tax rate from here. I mean, this does already give me a decent amount of money through tax. Not a lot, but an extra 5%, you know, what's the harm? So let's end the turn and see what Estalia do. They do obviously still have plenty of armies there. I also want to see what this Beastman Herd's going to do. If it's going to declare war on me or what. So you guys are just going to advance. with all your dumbass armies. I mean, oh my god, they're gonna come with all these agents as well, and all these Talia. I might just try and make peace with these guys, if I'm honest. Yeah, they're gonna go off into Elven territory.
Our lands prosper under your chivalrous rule, yet evil still breeds in every corner. Many look to destroy Britonia, and their power grows as quickly as your own. Stave off their advances, and unite the banners of Britonia through your chivalric actions.
So that's nice, but I don't know why we suddenly just lost like 500 gold from. I don't know where that went. I guess it's, oh, it's because we've got this army, right? It's because we just got all of these knights, I assume. But that's fine, we got some nice chivalry, we got the access to the green knight if we need him. I mean, he could probably come in pretty handy here, but fighting these armies, because I'm using a mod which actually makes the AI build normal armies instead of just like 17 units of missiles, which is pretty nice. I'm pretty tempted to go like ride out and meet these guys, because I have a really nice like defensive army. There's a lot of infantry here, but you know, that's not what's the worst that can happen. If this is successful, I think I'm going to push forward and assault them and smash back these Astalian units. Our lady demands. We were successful, so how many did we kill? Not many. I mean, quite a few, actually. Because if we attack this, the other army will get involved. Can this army get involved? If we force march them, they probably can, right? Agreed. Yeah, if we force march them, they can. So let's force march these guys to here.
Armored in faith.
And then go and attack. With the extra cavalry boost, I think we can beat both these armies here. And then we can just march. Oh, look at him on his hippogriff. That looks sick. And then we can march on to their capital and take that out. Because I don't think we'll be taking too many casualties. Like this right here, this army which we're looking at on the right hand side is a normal army. I don't see how they can't just program the AI to build an army like this. Like, it just makes no sense to me why they have like 16 units of missiles. It's just such a dumb way to play the game. Maybe AI fights better with it, but it's still just dumb nonetheless. So we are going to fight this. I might fight this live if I'm honest, because I've done a replay battle in the last one. Even though this is quite a big battle, I feel like we can just do some slow-mo bits and we'll just play it live. And then the next battle we do will be a replay one. Because I know a lot of people do still really enjoy like live battles. So hopefully you guys, the people who enjoy live battles, will enjoy this. But I will still like do slow-mos and stuff, so you know, it'll still hopefully be pretty cinematic for those guys who also enjoy the cinematic replays. Okay, we're in the battle now. Let's try and form up our forces. Again, we've got a very defensive army, so I kind of want to make the enemy, I want to force the enemy into coming into my range. Our trebuchets can already hit them from the get-go, so I think that's going to be enough to kind of encourage the enemy to push forward. So let's just form up a nice defensive formation around these guys. We can stick our cavalry up on these hills right here, which can then just charge down and smash the enemy, which will be perfect. So let's just set up our entire archer line here, because again, they just really have a bunch of infantry. Now, it's going to be a little bit scary. Like, maybe our infantry is not going to be able to hold. But then again, maybe they are. I don't have to worry about a lot of them getting shot to pieces. So I'm okay. The Battle Pilgrims are pretty decent as well, especially with the morale buff we have. These guys have 109 leadership. Like, that is insane. These guys are just never going to rout. They will fight to the death, which is great. And they're going to make up the center of my force. Then we'll stick the spearmen on the right and left-hand side. Yeah, with all these bonuses, I guess even my normal men-at-arms must have decent morale. Yeah, they all have 79 morale, which is the same as the Empire troops, so we're in a pretty good situation, and especially the foot squires as well will be doing great. Let's get all our knights up on this left-hand side. We obviously want to run these guys round here and smash the enemy in the back. We'll have Albrecht, even though he's not up to full strength, he will have to do work on his hippogriff. This is the first time I think we're seeing him on his hippogriff. I think that looks pretty great. I love how the hippogriffs just look at the camera. Oh, look at the artwork on the hippogriff as well. That's awesome. Yeah, he's going to be doing work this battle. Then we'll stick with spearmen on either flank, just as more of a defensive unit. And I think we're in a good space to start. Obviously, we've got reinforcements coming on, which are mainly just a cavalry, like a set of cavalry units. So let's unleash these guys. The artillery can shoot. All our troops are as well getting a huge boost, I think, straight away. Come on, boys. Let them feel the artillery. Oh, look at that. Let's go see the impacts. Nice. Because even if we miss the first rank, we're going to be hitting a lot of the second rank as well. So that's great. That's really, really good. So let's bring up the generals. I think this guy's on a warhorse now. He is indeed, which is good. I guess we can stick all of this cavalry off to this flank and just bring them through the woods. This unit of infantry can obviously come in, and obviously we'll bring in the general as well. So I guess the artillery just continue to volley as best as you can. Just smash their front line into the abyss. That would be great. Especially with all of the battle pilgrims and everything. definitely does look good, because the Battle Pilgrims should be more than enough to whittle down the enemy's front line. Oh, another shot there. Beautiful. I wonder how much damage, because again, because they've got three lines, we're just ripping apart this front line really, really effectively. And obviously all this cavalry is going to come flying down on the flanks. It should hopefully be a really, really nice battle. Got another general coming in. The archers, are they on range yet? Yeah, the archers are just about to come into range. Oh yeah, we should stick all my archers on guard mode as well, right? So they don't go chasing after enemies. That seems like a good idea. Yeah, look at that. The archers are brutal. That archer volley, oh my god, it's disgusting as we just look down the battle line like so. That is dangerous. They must be taking down so many of the enemy. And then the artillery coming off overhead. Oh, their general is coming flying in. Okay, cool. Let's go ahead and fight this then. We'll go and tell all our missiles on this left flank to, I guess, focus. I guess to hold fire, really. I guess all our missiles can hold fire now. Nothing really for us to shoot at. The infantry, obviously, Albert can go after their general. All this infantry can hold firm. All the artillery, I guess, can hold firm as well. Oh, let's be careful here. We've got a unit of spearmen. Let's bring down all this cavalry now. We don't want to get outflanked. We got another general as well. I guess we'll bring this general on this left flank. I want you guys to form wedge and come flying in there. Everyone else can hold. We got all this cavalry as well to come round. We'll stick you guys in wedge and come smash into these guys there. Seems like a good plan. The rest of the infantry should just be able to hold. We'll pop our rally, pop our sword, continue to fight their general. Oh, and I can get a perfect trident down here. Oh, look at that trident. I kind of wailed off a little bit towards the end, but I mean, it's going to be breaking this entire flank right here, so I guess that's kind of good. But general's getting smashed. All this artillery can now start changing focus to start shooting the soldiers coming in over here. All the cavalry's coming in as well. Actually, this unit of cavalry can come back. You guys can form up wedge and charge in there. Oh, we got a nice little charge here. Perfect. It's a little bit laggy. There is quite a lot of troops here. There's quite a few troops. Not that many. I swear we have more in online battles and it's not even that laggy. So yeah, you guys charge in there, form your wedge formation, and then you guys charge in there, form your wedge formation. Hopefully we'll be okay. You guys come in here. We wrap their general. Yeah, we did wrap their general. Perfect. Cavalry continue to fight hard. You guys get out of there now. You guys charge in there. Let's go get a nice little close-up of this. We still have an entire another army to fight, so we do have to be careful. But I mean, holy shit, look at that charge. I never get sick of seeing that. And this battle looks pretty sick as well. Let's get this cavalry out. We obviously need to, I think it's something I make a huge mistake of, is leaving my cavalry in the battles for way too long. We definitely need to keep on getting them out and charging them in, getting them out and charging them in. Obviously, you know, we can focus on, oh god, they've got their general right there. Missiles, unleash hell on him. Artillery, continue just to shoot their lines as best as you can. Just rinse this down. The amount of archer fire coming in, though, should be pretty horrific. Yeah, we got the artillery coming in as well. That's finding some big hits. I think we've routed pretty much their entire line. So all the cavalry just fall back now. We don't need you guys in there anymore. Get out of there. You guys can come smash these and help out my swordsmen. All the missile fire, though, is coming in, hitting their general, which I'm more than happy with. Oh, we have to be careful with their missiles. Let's get out of range. You guys can get out of the wedge formation now. Form up on this hill. You guys form up over here as well. Get out of wedge formation. All the missiles now? Yeah, who are shooting their general. He's now involved. So all the missiles just shoot into this big block of soldiers, I think. You guys come round a bit as well. Yeah, get out of there, knights. We don't need you guys in there anymore. Albrecht, how you doing? You're in here just fighting away. Where's their general gone? I want to find the general. He's in here somewhere. Well, this cavalry now can come down the hill, though, and smash their missiles. Oh, yeah, we got this other general there just fighting some spearmen. I really want to find out. Oh, God, this is going to be great. Oh, ripping through so many soldiers. Yeah, I want to find out where their general is. That'd be a nice, nice thing to find. Because if we can focus him down, that's not him. That's not him. It's really hard to see on this new model as we get all our cavalry come smashing in against their archers. Beautiful. Take them down, boys. Slaughter these crossbows. We get rid of their missile advantage. They're pretty useless. And Albrecht on top of his hippogriff is just a force to be reckoned with. Battle Pilgrims, I guess, can advance. And I think a lot of their forces... Oh, we got some cavalry caught there. That is not good. Get out of there, boys. Come round here. yeah, you guys are coming into here to kill some more missiles. It's missile killing time, and you are in the right place to see some missiles getting run down. What do you need? We got some more coming here. You guys continue to chase them. We've got some cavalry. Oh, we need to be careful not to get caught. They're definitely causing me a pretty big nuisance here. All our missiles, again, can just shoot into here or whatever. Don't really mind too much. You can come back and help out the spearmen. Cavalry chase down them. You guys come out here, smash into here, help out them guys. You guys are actually going to rout, which is fair enough. There's a lot of missiles you guys are fighting. And again, the cavalry keeps getting caught. Well, I keep on getting caught with the cavalry. Move in, Albrecht. Come help out the main fight here, I think. Oh, you also have some swordsmen here as well. Foot squires, get involved. Come around this flank. We've got some infantry here we can come and bring round. And we're about to smash their line. Holy shit. Beautiful. That's going to rout the enemy line. Artillery can continue to shoot at the soldiers back here. Just anyone routing, really. It's fine with me. Turn around and hit there, which is fine. You guys come around here and charge in. Same with you guys, go get involved there. All our missiles now actually focus down that unit of archers right there. I don't think I'm honestly going to have men to come and help out. You guys charge in there. Actually, no, you guys come over here. This cavalry come over here, I think, will be the best idea. How you doing, Albrecht? Pop your rally. Pop your good sword. And hopefully that general is in here somewhere. It's hard to see where he actually is. We've got more men-at-arms coming in here. But, I mean, he must be in here somewhere, right? So I can't really see a single soldier just running around the battlefield. Maybe he is here somewhere. But he's just also swordsmen. Yeah, we've got a few horsemen actually running from the battlefield, being overwhelmed by the missiles. Which is fine, obviously. We've got this general unit to come help out, though. Come help out there. You guys come hit their missiles. And our missiles are continually just... Yeah, we managed to rout them. We've got cavalry coming now down here. Perfect. All the artillery as well is coming in here. Yeah, continue to focus down these guys. I think this battle is pretty much over, if I'm honest. The amount of missile fire. Look at the fire arrows right there. And then obviously the cavalry charge as well, running down them crossbows. And another cavalry charge over here, running down these crossbows. Don't know what these swordsmen are doing. Yeah, they're getting the right idea and running the hell out of there. How you doing, Albrecht? Nice, you got this left. I really don't want to hit my own men, but here we go. Be big. Oh, we're going to hit some of our own men. I think that's worth it, though, if I'm honest. That ripped through the back of the enemy line. Yeah, I did a lot of damage. I actually got some missiles fighting here as well. A few of my archers who have been caught in the battle. That's fine. This battle's actually a lot closer than I was anticipating it to be. Just mainly because I can't find the enemy general. He's here somewhere, but I have no idea where. Yeah, you guys can come back now. We probably need you guys to help out over here. The other general is stuck in here. Come help out these guys. Infantry line is winning the day. Pop your rally. We obviously need Albrecht to stay alive if we can help it. That would be a swell if he could stay alive. These missiles, I guess, just focused on some enemy missile fire there. You guys charge into there, and then we got this cavalry charging into here. And that should be all she wrote, I think, for the battle. I think I got some half-decent cinematic shots here. Hopefully you guys enjoy this battle replay live. I think a lot of people enjoy like a mix of both. And this way, you know, it's just the easiest thing to kind of do both. I mean, this has been a great battle for us. We have killed a ton of enemy forces. Obviously, they can rebuild them, but we can just take on replenishment and then move forward. This battle would have been a lot quicker as well if I would have known where the goddamn enemy general has been. Because I have no idea where he is at the moment. Clean up the rest of these guys. We've got this general still remaining. We lost a lot of cavalry. I get really, really bad at like leaving my cavalry involved in engagements. I really, really do. I don't think I need to chase down many of these guys. I'm pretty sure Albrecht will be able to run down the majority of the soldiers. So we'll go ahead and end the battle. We don't need to save a replay because I'm not doing a replay of it. And we'll see. So we lost in total about 1,000 soldiers out of our 2,000. Whereas they lost, what, like 3,000? Yeah, just over 3,000 troops out of their 4,000. So, you know, we definitely killed a lot. I mean, and look at Albrecht. He almost got 300 goddamn kills on top of his Hippogriff. Not at full health as well. Archers and crossbows. I mean, archers and trebuchets doing great. The cavalry doing amazing. And obviously on foot squires as well, really showing their worth, which is amazing. So hopefully now we can push on to their capital and just wipe out Astalia. Because that means that they won't be able to spam out these 2.5 stacks worth of armies for no reason every single turn.
Yo,
was that much of a Pyrrhic victory. We did actually lose a load of men, though. We lost pretty much the whole... Well, we lost an entire Battle Pilgrim, you know, which is kind of annoying. We did level up as well to level 16, or almost level 16, gain some chivalry, obviously gain some money. So I'm just going to take the extra boost. We got Savior as well, charge bonus, and speed for army. That's really, really good. So we'll take that. Well, it's for this army, but I mean, it's still really, really good. And then we can't march on and chase them down, which is unfortunate, because I would very much like to hit them, but I don't think we can, and he obviously can't reach them either. Why can't you continue on? Because I would very much like to hit these guys. I'm going to keep on charging. And then we can also give up a unit of horsemen as well over here. We obviously did lose a unit of battle pilgrims, but that's fine. So you guys go there, and you guys go there, that's fine. So that'll be a nice little defense. Our paladin leveled up as well. It'd also be helpful if we maybe had this paladin in the army, because he's such a tank at the moment. You know, he has, what, 58 melee defense and 59 melee attack. Is that more than Albrecht? Where is it? Yeah. Overall, it is. Obviously, his melee defense is much lower. So it just means that this guy is going to take so much damage. It's going to be pretty insane. So we'll keep on pushing on them. Hopefully, Talia don't send any armies. Even though I don't think they will because we've smashed them. But obviously, this army could be a bit of a nuisance and come down. But I think that we're strong enough in the garrison here that the garrison would be able to hold out. Because it is a siege battle as well. So I think we'd be okay there. Money-wise, we're obviously a bit bankrupt right now, which isn't great, if I'm honest. We could upgrade this so we can get some battle pilgrims. And that would also free up a space over here if we needed it. Yeah, this place is actually kind of unhappy as well. So maybe, I mean, I don't know. Maybe we should just leave it for now. Because realistically, what I want to do, what I want to happen is, for one, upgrade this. But two, what I want to happen is I want to just win the war down here. Like, take out Astalia to clean up this province and then hopefully just make peace with Talia. I don't really want to continue my crusade down here. And then we can really focus on building up our forces in the center. Oh, that's why we're losing the money. The Bray Herd is actually attacking me there. It's just whatever. That's fine. This army probably isn't strong enough to take it out, if I'm honest, with an auto-resolve, just because it's so many missiles. The Grail Knights, though, look beautiful. Let's end the turn, see what the enemy do. Hopefully, I mean, they might come and attack me. I think a balance of power would be in my favor, just because we just smashed them. I'm hoping they're not going to come and attack me either, because if they came and took my city, I'd be so annoyed. They're just some agents doing their annoyance thing. Yeah, they're just going to retreat back, which is fine. And it's kind of annoying, because it means we have to retreat back now, because we can't smash their armies and the garrison, I don't think. So that's a bit frustrating, if I'm honest. Now I'm just going to recruit some more men. It's pretty annoying. So these guys did declare war on me. What are they going to do? Yeah, whatever. Boys can come. Hopefully they might actually send some armies. They're just going to besiege me. If they just besiege me, that's fine. I've got time. So they killed one of my dudes, by the looks of it. They kill this dude. Or they kill my paladin. No, my paladin is still alive. So let's use our paladin to kill this guy, assassinate him. See you later, mate. Get out of my face. So I guess we just have to move back to base. It's such a tedious thing. Because we're just going to recruit, they're going to recruit, and then we're just going to fight the exact same battle we just fought there. But I guess maybe it's my fault for not having an army to follow up there. So let's bring back this army. We can even move up to Talia and take out that force. But we need to replenish for now. Get ourselves back to former strength. Our paladin, who has been a beast this entire time, can continue just to mess up the enemy. I mean, what's our... Okay, not great odds. Just because... I mean, come on, like... AI, have a good normal army, like, not just a set of, like, they've got probably got more Minotaurs in that army than they do anything else. I mean, in a siege battle, what are the Minotaurs going to do? Like, we have so many missiles, they're just going to get shot to pieces. It's not even going to be funny, so if they want to siege me, they're more than welcome to. And it actually does mean that we're making a bit of money now as well, so that's always good. Make a bit of cash. So what should we build here? What were we building here for our last one? A stable, right? Even though we don't really need the stable, I don't think. Oh no, we do need the stable here because we need to the armorer here as well. So let's start getting on the way on building that. I mean, actually, we don't need the stable there quite yet because we're not building any cavalry at any point. Could upgrade that, don't really need to. Province down here is absolutely fine. Province down here is absolutely... Oh, we can get some more iron. So we'll do that, more money, more trade. Because how are we doing on trade? Where are we? Oh, that's wrong bottom, right? We have to go down to commercial to have a look. Yeah, trade's almost up to a grand, so that's not bad. I'm kind of happy with that. And again, I guess we just end the turn. So we do have the access to the Green Knight, but I really don't want to just use up the Green Knight on attacking, you know, Talia. I've already used one charge on attacking him. I'd much rather... Well, Marienburg are coming down, so we do need to raise another army. I don't understand why they're coming down to attack me when they just ran. Did Bretonnia make peace with them? If Bretonnia made peace with them, I'm going to be pissed. Because now I'm just left in a war with them for no reason. We are also continuing to use our hero as well.
Paladin of Bretonnia.
Paladin of Bretonnia. Let's go kill this captain. I think he's more of a... Oh, really? Why is he so... I don't understand that, why there's such a poor positive outcome when we can kill them everywhere else. Or him as well. Yeah, when we're around this city, they're pretty much impossible to kill. So I guess we'll just move over here and like assault some units, I guess. And it was a success. Great, he got aggressor. Nice. And he also got strict as well. That's actually really good. And we obviously wounded all of them dudes. Albrecht leveled up to level 16. Great, great, great. We could get the Grail Vow. Don't really need that right now. I don't think any of these are that great. Charge bonus is pretty nice. But again, we don't really need that. We have Protector of the Realm, which is just a boost to bonus first large for Knights of the Realm. So that's not even that great. We just continue down Scarred Veteran, I think. Keep on giving him a ton of health. So we do have a few issues for us to deal with. She leveled up as well. Well, what should we give? Earthblood, I think, is really good. It replenishes HP. Or also Light Bloom as well. Or Life Bloom. That's awesome. We can also put on a fucking unicorn as well. Don't know what the AI was doing with this building thing. But yeah, let's go ahead and put her on silver on her unicorn. You seek prophecy. We'll continue to let them siege us. And I guess we have to build an army. I mean, I would like to make peace with Marienburg if I can. Because for some reason... Yeah, for some reason, they've made peace with them and they're still attacking me. Like, they're not going to. Cool, let's spam out an army then and go fucking kill them. So we got another hero we can raise, which is fine. It's going to... Oh, we don't even have the money to do that. I don't even know why I recruited him. We have the money to do it. We're going to go bankrupt next turn. So let's get rid of him. That was so bad for me. I should have just looked. But yeah, we're going to have to lose a province, unfortunately. And I think this army is going to have to move back. Does anyone want to make peace with me? Because, I mean, I can kill all these armies. It's just more effort than it's worth, really. Deadly Onslaught you can get. Give him more weapon strength. We don't really need more leadership. Could also give him more armor as well. Beast that bad boy up. Obviously, could give him a Pegasus as well. I kind of like him on a warhorse. Because I only really... I just boost his charge bonus, but not anything else. It gives him a little bit more health. Let's just boost up his weapon strength. Yeah, why the hell not? Because, what, at 15%, he goes up pretty nicely. He goes up to like 450, I think. So just keep on making him into a monster at killing the enemy. I brought Albrecht back instead of that. Let's see if any of Talia or Astalia want to make peace. I wouldn't be surprised if Astalia wanted to make peace.
The time for talk is over.
Yeah, Astalia wanted to make peace. I'd much rather just go make peace with Talia, if I'm honest.
The time for talk is over. Make your
Yeah, cool. Making peace with Talia is great, because that means I can make peace with both of them, but I really want to take this. But then again, I have to deal with these assaults coming from Marienburg and everyone else, because obviously this city has been lost. Like, I doubt it. There's no legendary lord there, so I doubt we can hold this. For some reason, fucking Bretonnia betrayed us. But I mean, he has to come back, but we also have to obviously deal with all of these armies as well. Don't really have the money to do anything. But yeah, I mean, I guess you go back there. We have to deal with these armies, and we kind of just have to let what happens to our realm happen. You can all get destroyed now, I think. Well, let's merge them, I think. And combine. Let's merge some of this cavalry together as well. You guys merge. Like so. And then we'll give you one more unit of horsemen. Yeah, we'll give you them. Then you come back here ready to push on them, and you just get destroyed so we actually have some money. Yeah, 500 gold is fine. We just have to try and just slow these guys down as much as possible. So what I'm probably going to do right now is do that, which is going to make it unhappy, but then just come and assault them. Oh, I can't assault them. Of course I can't. Okay, just ignore that then. And we just have to hold there for now. So we just have to try and keep the enemy at bay for as long as possible there. Until we can finish off the last of Astalia, which shouldn't be too long, realistically. We should just be able to smash our armies, because they're still depleted. As long as our paladins there keep on harassing them. Marienburg obviously have another army, because why would they not? I'm really pissed at Bretonnia, if I'm honest. Yeah, you're going to come here and just be an annoyance. I don't know why I couldn't say that there. I mean, hopefully our paladin can deal with him. Try to assault it. We killed him. Nice. Good job. I guess we just go there, and then we get ready to push there. So one more turn of replenishment. and then we just push on their armies, I guess? Absolutely not. We don't really have a lot, if I'm honest. If we just attack them and attack an army outside, we probably should be okay. And so if we can keep on getting some, we don't have any money to do that. That's not good. I mean, oh yeah, we can, maybe, oh yeah, it probably wasn't the rate, it was just we didn't have any enough money. So I'm going to assault this, just because I think that's worth my money. We failed, unfortunately. But it'd be nice to get some of these units down. Also, Brittany, you better come join this war. Like, I'm going to invite them to join this goddamn war, which they've apparently left me in. They're going to reject, if they reject that, they're probably not going to join this war, if I'm honest.
Speak, and I will see if it is within my power to give.
What if I join your godforsaken war you've been trying to drag me into for the past year? Where does it say? Join war? Oh, yeah, I do have to redo it. Probably have to redo it, right? Join war against... I'll join war against them if you join a war against them. No, you won't. So you dragged me into this goddamn war against them, and now you're just going to ignore me. That is great. Will you guys join me in my war? You might actually confederate with me. That'd be nice, but we don't need to do it right now, I don't think. Join my war. Will you join my war against Marienburg? No, you won't. Okay, cool. Whatever. We'll just have to fight them. That's fine. I mean, we can do it. It's easy to kill them. You know, the AI really doesn't present a challenge. It's just the sheer amount of armies they have. And it really does create a tedious behavior. Like, it's just killing army after army after army. Like, this is going to piss me off if they do this. I might... Yeah, we need to move. We need to be quick here. They're pissing off, which is fine. We need to smash their province because I really want to take out their province there. Oh, what's rioting? Begone. Oh, this is rioting. Well, I mean, it's going to rebel to rebels, so that's fine. So, by the looks of it, they're going to come here, so we have to recruit a lord here. Do we have one? We do actually have a... Where's our three lords? I swear... Oh, she just came back. I guess we'll get her then, because the other lords aren't back yet. Devotee of the lady. And we'll stick her in there. We'll stick the paladin down here as well, just to stop him from coming in and assaulting us here. And we'll just try and recruit some men if we can. Just get some, like, sword infantry. So expensive, though. We really can't afford it. See what I mean? Like, we're literally stretched. And I mean, I guess this being under siege is a real issue. Because how many turns do we even have left before we start running out of supplies? Does it not tell me? It does tell me somewhere, right? I'm just not looking in the right place. As if I hover over this, right? Four more turns before supplies. So realistically, what needs to happen... is you need to come and smash their army next turn, which we can definitely do. Lord. You get there ready to smash their army. We need to kill this army, then we need to move all the way over here, kill them, and then come up and kill them. I think that's our only real bet here, I think. Knight, so let's continue to, and we don't have enough money to do so, which is fine. No problem there. Okay, cool. I think I'm going to end the episode here. Keep this episode kind of shortish, 35 minutes-ish long. So things are looking pretty bad for us, if I'm honest. Like, we're not bad, you know. All we have to do is move our one army, because apparently that's all we can really afford. You know, because I wouldn't really class this as a full army. You know, it's a couple units. We've got some expensive units, which we could think about getting rid of. But, I mean, like, it's just dumb. Like, how can they field this many units with one province? And I, you know, I've got like 6 or 7 and I can field, you know, fewer units than them. Luckily, we have, like, and we've been focusing on economy, may I mention, since the beginning of the game. We spent 12 grand on building this, and that's, like, we can only just about handle 2 armies, not even 2 armies. And we've got all our stuff set to taxes as well. It does get kind of ridiculous. I can actually get the Green Knight here as well. Maybe not, because I think he spawns by Alberic. So, yeah, anyway, hopefully you guys are enjoying this series so far. If you are, make sure to drop a like and a comment down below, and I'll see you guys next time, and fish out.